All right, let's talk about the nuclear arms race. Now, the nuclear arms race is going to be a competition for supremacy in nuclear warfare. Now, this is going to go on between the United States and the USSR primarily. Now, there were going to be other countries going that are involved in the nuclear arms race, primarily the allies of the United States. For example, like the United Kingdom and France are going to be getting nuclear weapons at this time period. But the arms race is primarily going to be done between the United States and the Soviet Union. Initially, the United States is going to be the ones who are superior in their manufacturing of arms. Okay, so we know already from history that the United States was the first country to develop a nuclear weapon. Stalin is going to know about this through his spies. He's not going to be particularly excited about this, and it's going to lead to him creating his first nuclear weapon in 1949 as well. But this is going to lead to an arms race. The Soviet goal was not only to catch up to have the same number of nuclear weapons that the United States had, but also to go and surpass that, because a nuclear weapon is a major deterrent. If you only have a strong military, but the opponent you are fighting has a number of nuclear weapons, they're going to have the upper hand, and that's not going to be something you want to be a part of. That's like going into a fight and finding out you've only got your fist while your opponent is going to have a gun. Your opponent is going to win that fight because it's a lot easier for them to do so. So the Soviets want to make sure they catch up and at least have a gun, so to speak, in this same fight, but not just one gun. They're going to want to make sure they have multiple. Okay, so you're going to have more than your opponent, making it easier for you to defeat them. Nuclear weapons are going to be a major deterrent, as I was just saying. If you know that if you invade someone, they might drop a nuke on you, you're going to be a lot less likely to invade them. And this is still one of those theories going on today, mutually assured destruction, which we talked about. Basically, if you drop a nuke on them, they're going to drop a nuke back on you. So you're much less likely to invade a country that has a nuclear weapon simply because it could end badly for you. The ideal nuclear weapon was on a missile. Why on a missile? Because it's easy to transport them. You can simply launch them. They're going to go up to space, come back down, and explode in a matter of about 15 to 20 minutes, depending on where your target is and where it's being launched from. Compared to flying your nuclear weapon on a bomb, it's going to take a lot longer. Dropping it is just not near as efficient. So putting it on a missile, it's going to make it a lot more efficient, easier to hit targets. This is going to lead to nuclear fear, which was the belief that nuclear war would happen. Okay, people building up all these weapons. The belief is if you have all these weapons, you're going to be using these weapons. This is going to lead to a nuclear war. So if you see here, this is going to be a graph of the nuclear arms race. So initially, the United States is going to have the advantage when it comes to the number of nuclear warheads. However, the Soviets are going to eventually come up and ultimately dominate the United States initially. However, they're going to start selling those off as soon as the Soviet Union. Destroying them as soon as the Soviet Union ceases to exist. So that is all for the nuclear arms race. Questions, comments, put it down below. Otherwise, I will see you later.